So I'm pumped and ready to meet Dilesh, who owns D22, an IT outfit out in Middelburg.
Here we are.
Dilesh!
Hi, Dilesh.
How are you doing?
Good morning, how are you?
Very well, thanks.
You're welcome. Please come in. Thanks. Can I offer you a cup of coffee?
Some coffee, that'd be nice.
Come through.
Well, Dilesh, the last time we were here, crack of dawn, barely had a chance to get a glass of water, let alone a cup of coffee.
Okay.
You must be doing something different. Tell us about it.
I think after the show, a lot of changes, some positive ones. Uh-huh. Good advice has been given to us. We've been able to apply it, put some clever time management tools in place. We've got some good measurement tools.
Uh-huh.
And yeah, all the difference, all around. I think seeing is believing. We should head out that way.
All right, let's do it.
Let's go.
Nothing on the outside could have prepared me for how it looks in here. Fantastic. You're definitely taking time more seriously now. With clocks that big, I mean, I haven't seen a clock that big since what? I was in London.
I think the point is not to miss it, eh?
Uh-huh.
Service, service, service. That's what important to us. The three clocks represent, firstly, South African time.
Uh-huh.
What's the time right now? Second one is about 45 minutes ahead.
Uh-huh.
And that's when we need to be at the customer, giving them the service that they need. Third one is if a code request comes in or we have to generate the invoice, by that time, we need to have it out.
And then? New faces, meaning what? You are delegating.
Some of the advice given from the show.
Uh-huh.
We obviously want to apply leverage, get better time management, buy back my time.
Uh-huh.
We've got two brilliant team leaders who are taking care of, a brilliant team who works underneath them. And yeah, we're taking from there, moving from stride to stride.
Okay, and the calendar on the back to keep everyone knowing where they're meant to be and keeping everyone focused on respecting time?
That's it, online calendar.
Mm-hmm.
And basically what we're doing is everyone knows anywhere, any place, anytime, what's going on, who needs to be where, what's taking place right now. That just gives us better measurement tools.
A lot of businesses could use improvements in the way of cash flow, but your business needed particular attention in that area. What have you done to improve?
Well, based after the show, Dan has given us some good advice, some good basic principles like the 80% deposit, which helped us a hell of a lot on our cash flow.
Okay, so what did you do? You actually went back to your clients and started asking for more upfront.
If the deal wanted to go through, obviously the customer would have the funds available to them.
Uh-huh.
So instead of us taking the risk and us being the bank, we would then ask the customer to lay down the 80% deposit, and that just helped us a bit on our side. It's all about relationship at the end of the day. It's also about adding value and what you call being consistent with what you're saying.
Okay.
So, yeah.
So what about prioritizing who you spend your time with, or at least where you develop your business and that kind of
that's
thing?
That's it. Bill has given good advice in last year, and that's saying investing your time, not spending it.
Yeah.
And obviously, we invested it in our clients. That's the 80-20 rule.
Mm-hmm.
Investing in the clients is actually adding the value to the company and bringing in the numbers.
Mm-hmm.
And we're spending quite a lot of time going to do courtesy visits, make sure they're happy with our services, deepen it instead of widening our spread of customers. One thing we've been fortunate with, or one of the implementations we've put in, is we put in a CRM program. It tells us how much of cash flow or how much of business is going to come from the clients. Tells us what value they are adding to us and when also we can close off
the
deal.
Well, Dilesh, I am pretty pleased to see that all the advice, the tips and the techniques that you were given last year are really finding their way into making your business that much more amazing.
Advice is good, but obviously you need to take action, and I think we've done
you
it.
You have to get up and do stuff yourself, and
that's
you're
it.
Certainly doing that.
Thank you so much. Appreciate it.
All the best going forward.
Good stuff. You too.
Well, don't go away. We met some amazing characters and businesses last year, and we're going to go back to find out just how much of our advice they've been able to implement to improve their businesses. We meet the boys from the Shack next and find out if they've been able to change the look of their business a year down the line. It's My Biz, the big show for small business. And before we get going next week with the fantastic analysis and advice for the businesses that are going to be featuring in our second exciting series this year, we're visiting some of the entrepreneurs who came to us last year because we want to see now if they've had the focus it takes to take our advice. So we're about to go to downtown Joburg to check in with three young guys who began in a backyard shack in Soweto. because we want to know just how they're doing in actively promoting themselves and their business.